Well, Roisin is one of 8 naval vessels within the Naval Service. She was built in 1999, so she's just coming on 12 years now. She has a range of about 6,000 miles and the capacity of a crew for 43 on board is our total complement. As one of the naval vessels, she's a multitask vessel. We have a range of roles. Obviously, our primary role is defence of the state under the Defence Act, but our secondary roles encompass such things as fish protection, search and rescue, drug interdiction, weapons interdiction. Less known ones are flying the flag abroad for things like Department of Foreign Affairs, the IDA, Enterprise Ireland, and these are a very important part of our service to government as well. One of the big things about the ship is that we're a multi-skilled, multifaceted organisation. We have a small footprint and we can change our operational profile very easily from being in fish protection in the morning, search and rescue by afternoon. Early in the evening, we can be told that we're doing a drug interdiction operation and to carry out surveillance. And then in dark, in pretty bad weather conditions, we can involve a naval boarding team having to go on board a vessel, seize it, and search it for contraband. In fact, this particular vessel had a very notable success in 2008 when it was involved in the detention of the yacht Dancing with Waves. She was bringing in 2 tons of cocaine into the country, and the criminals that were involved in that operation are now currently serving 10-year sentences.
I'm Lieutenant Jim O'Donovan, and I'm the navigator of the naval vessel Roisin, and this is the brains of the operation up here, the bridge of the ship. This is where we navigate the ship from day to day. My job as navigator is to make sure that the vessel travels safely through pilotage waters at all times, efficiently moves from point A to point B. I'm also a boarding officer on board, so my job is going onto the fishing vessels and ensuring that everything is up to spec on board, that they don't have illegal nets, have undersized fish or anything like that. So, as I say, this is the brains of the operation. The captain's chair is here. He sits in the middle. Myself as navigator, I'm standing here in front of the electronic charts, echo sounder, radar. And then the officer watches standing out front. I'm giving information to him on where to drive, where it's safe to drive. And the captain, sitting behind me, is overseeing the entire operation.
Really, we stand poised. That sounds very formal, but that's what we do. There isn't an external threat to Ireland at the moment. And our job is to train to be able to deal with that threat if and when it comes, in whatever manner government sees to challenge us by responding to it. And we do that on a day-by-day basis. By training regularly, we train for our own defence, we train for an operation.
We have a very, very important
in a joint unit with the Naval Base, which is called FORST, and they actually come on board for a week. And it's like having the school inspector come. We're inspected from myself right down to the ordinary seaman on board, and we're challenged to prove that we're capable of dealing and executing all of the operational requirements that the government and the Defence Force have set us.